Time for some email.
Yay.
Yay.
It's time to bring it on.
That's a good attitude. Okay. On a Friday. Okay. This is from Dorothy Gordon, who says, I have a born-again friend who's in a church that does not believe in displaying the cross. They seem to be ashamed of it. What scriptures can I give my friend to open her eyes that she may be in a cult?
Dorothy, I'm sort of taken back with the question that, you know, she may be in a cult. There's got to be a whole lot more here to establish that some groups are cult and they just don't display a cross in their church. I mean, that's there are plenty of churches that are perfectly fine churches that don't display the cross. If you're looking for scripture, there's a wonderful one that Paul wrote in Corinthians, where he said, "I determined to know nothing among you." He'd just come in from Athens and he had preached the sermon at Mars Hill. And it's interesting that from that sermon, there was no church established. You don't see the letter to the church in Athens. I think it's one of the best sermons of all time, but he was grieving, I think, that he hadn't had results. And so he said to the Corinthians, "I came to you in fear and trembling, resolving that I would preach nothing but Jesus Christ and Him crucified." That there's a power to that that changes people. The gospel is the power of God unto salvation. I am not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God. I remember being in Finland and visiting an ancient church that had been there since the 7th century. And they gave us free access, and I was able to... They had one of these pulpits that rose above the congregation, and you had to walk up steps into it. And as I looked, I saw that verse. I didn't read Finnish, but I knew enough that that was the verse. And it was the preacher, every time he would walk up into that pulpit, had that verse right in front of him. I resolved to preach nothing but Christ and Him crucified. We need to realize that for a lot of people, it's a stumbling block. It's a shame. They don't understand it. But it is the power of God to salvation.
This is Karen, who says, is it wise to store freeze-dried food in these hard times, or is it a lack of faith not to trust in Jesus to take care of me when things get tough?
Karen, you might want to look at the expiration date on that stuff. you know, I hear this, and boy, I tell you, it sometimes strikes me as a waste of money. That are you putting a lot of money into freeze-dried food that you then store and just let it go bad, and literally you're throwing away your money. If you really want to get serious about some kind of survivalist thing, I was in New Orleans right after Katrina, and I saw what happened to a city that had no cell phone service, no fresh water, no food, no food deliveries, no food on the grocery stores, nothing. And so you couldn't call anybody for help. You couldn't drink water. You couldn't eat. And if you ever get into that situation, whatever you've got in the stores is going to go real quick. You know, if you're really going to get serious, I heard of a family decided to move to New Zealand.
That's the expensive way to get ready for that.
And live on a farm. So unless you really want to get serious and say, I'm going to be a farmer from now on and be self-sufficient, you're not going to have enough to see you through.